हेलो चिल्ड्रन, कैसे हैं? यस, एज यू नो ऑन लास्ट मॉड्यूल वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर चैप्टर सिस्टम ऑफ पार्टिकल एंड रोटेशनल मोशन. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एन अनदर न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज एनसीईआरटी चैप्टर नंबर 8, दैट इज ग्रेविटेशन. Gravitation. First, I want to explain what is the meaning of gravitation. Dear children, this term we have seen in 9th class also. So just rememorize it. What is gravitation? Gravitation is the name given to the force of attraction. It is the force of attraction. It is the force of attraction any two bodies of the universe. Force of attraction of any two bodies of universe. Of the universe that we know very well. It is clear? This was discovered by which scientist? Sir, it is Newton. Newton discovered gravitation in the year 1665 when he saw an apple falling down from the tree. That we know very well. Suppose this is the apple in my hand and falling down. That was first observed by Newton. The gravitational force is the weakest force among the four fundamental forces of nature. It is the weakest force that we have seen in first chapter. Among the four fundamental forces of nature. Okay? Yes. But it is important force because it is played an important role in initiating the birth of stars. It is initiating the birth of stars and controlling the entire structure of the universe. It controls the entire structure of the universe. That is why we are using here. So the gravitational force has a significant application in the present advancement of physics. Is that clear? So it is a very, very important law that we are going to learn. Yes. Write down what is Newton's law of gravitation that we have seen in 9th class also. Again, we are going to see in brief. So Newton's law of gravitation. Newton's law of gravitation. Yes. Can you imagine? See, you are in 9th class. Then think, immediately you can rememorize it. Suppose we are having here the two bodies, one body and this is the another body. Suppose this body is A and this body is B. The distance in between the two bodies is say R. The force acting from this to this and from this to this, say it is F12. This is the first body and this is the second body. And from this to this, say the force is F21. Both are equal and opposite. So what is the Newton's law of gravitation? What it states that? So I can say, my dear children, it states that everybody in the universe attracts every other body. Attracts every other body with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses. Which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them that we have seen in 9th class. So my dear children, we are considering as the two mass A and B, say of mass M1 and M2 respectively. Distance here is R. F be the force of attraction between them. Then according to the Newton's law of gravitation, what I can write? Just I told you, it is the directly proportional to the product of the two masses and inversely proportional to the square of its distance. Here I can use the constant of proportionality is capital G, that is m1 m2 divided by r square. Here G is called constant of proportionality and it is also called universal gravitational constant. What is it called? Write down universal gravitational constant. Universal gravitational constant. Here. So what is the definition of G here? If I suppose that when you are taking both the mass m1 and m2 having values 1 unit, m1 and m2 both are 1, and suppose the distance in between the two bodies is also 1 meter, mass is 1 kg, so I can write F is equal to G m1 m2 divided by r square, that is only G. So you can see F is equal to G here. What is this? So here the universal gravitational constant is equal to the universal gravitational constant is equal to the force of attraction acting between the two bodies, each of unit mass, whose centers are placed unit distance apart. Kitna distance rakha hua ek dusre ke beech mein? Unit distance. Write down. Now, gravitational constant is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar quantity. Its value is same throughout the universe. Its value is same throughout the universe and it is independent of the nature and size of the body is also. It is independent. As well as the nature of the medium between the two bodies. The value of G in the standard international MKS unit or SI unit, that is 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton into meter square kg minus 2. That also we have seen earlier. What is the dimensional formula of G that we have learned in first chapter? M minus 1. L3 T minus 2. You can get it from here because we know F is equal to G M1 M2 by R square. So if you want to find out the dimensional formula of G, so this is F into R square divided by M1 M2. Here. From this, you can find out the dimensional formula of force M1 L1 T minus 2. Distance is L, here is M and here it is M. M ki power 2 because all are 1, so it is M minus 1. L ki power 1 here, M1, mass into acceleration. So I can say here, how it is, force into distance, R square, sorry, this is L2. M minus 1. L3 T minus 2. This is the formula here. This formula holds good for all the objects having a very large distance and also at a very short distance. In both the cases, this formula I can use. Okay? Yes. Likh lijiye. Now, so now, dear children, I am going to see the next article, that is, what do you mean by gravitational field? What is the meaning of gravitational field? Here I can say gravitational field. What is this? Now, I want to explain what is that that is gravitational field. I know very well that earth attracts everybody towards its center like this. It is going down. It attracts towards the center. So according to the Newton's law of gravitation, the force of attraction varies inversely as the square of its distance, that we know, of the body from the center of the earth. What this shows? This shows that in the space all around the earth, its gravitational pull can be experienced. Gravitational pull that can be experienced by other material bodies. That is true for every material body. So I can say the space around a material body in which its gravitational pull can be experienced, in which its gravitational pull can be experienced. Okay, this is called gravitational field. Write down the space around a material body. This is called gravitational field. According to this field, I can say a metal particle placed in space modifies the space around it. So this space is called gravitational field. Okay, now I want to find out here intensity of gravitational field. Intensity of a gravitational field. What is that? What is the meaning of intensity here? The intensity of a gravitational field, I can explain here, of a body. Intensity of a gravitational field of a body at a point in the field. Of a body at a point in a field. In a field is defined as the force experienced by the body. Force experienced by a body. Force experienced by a body. By a body of unit mass. Of unit mass placed at that point. Placed at that point. Provided the presence of unit mass does not disturb the original gravitational field. It will not disturb the original gravitational field. It is always directed towards the center of the gravity. It is always directed towards the center of gravity of the body whose gravitational field is considered. So intensity of gravitational field at a point, I can say, is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. Intensity of gravitational field. And it is denoted by a symbol I, like this. Here is the symbol. Now, I want to find out what is the formula of it. Let us see. The formula for the intensity of a gravitational field, let M be the mass of a body with center of gravity at a point O. Say this is. Let F be the gravitational force of attraction experienced by a rest mass, say situated here. M naught, it is a rest mass, when placed at the point P. In the gravitational field of the body, the distance in between the O and P is x. Then according to the Newton's law of gravitation, I can write F is equal to G M M naught divided by x square. This is our equation number one. These are the two bodies here. Then the intensity of gravitational field at the point P would be force experienced by a unit mass, F by M naught. So I can write G M M naught divided by x square by M naught. So this is, I am getting here GM by x square only. In vector form, it is towards the center of the gravity. So I can write in the vector form I, that is, it is attractive force, that is GM by x square. And x cap is the unit vector, that is towards this. Here the negative sign shows that the gravitational intensity is of attractive force, sir. Yes. Niklo. जैसे जैसे अगर x बढ़ेगा, suppose if x increases, I decreases. When x is equal to infinity, say, तो I becomes zero. जैसे जैसे डिस्टेंस बढ़ेगी then I decreases. It means that intensity of a gravitational field is zero only at infinite distance from the body. Okay? Yes. Now, what is the unit of intensity of gravitational field? That is in SI system, Newton per kg. This is. Okay? So you can write this. What is the dimensional formula here? Also, I barabar F by M naught. Force ka likhiye, M L1 T minus 2, M1 L1 T minus 2 divided by mass. So only we are getting this is. This is the dimensional formula. Okay? Likh lijiye. Now, I want to see what is gravitational potential. Here we are going to learn another small article, that is gravitational potential. Here, what is this? Gravitational potential at a point in a gravitational field. Is defined as the amount of work done, in bringing a body, of unit mass, from infinity, to that point without acceleration, This is the called gravitational potential. If suppose W is the amount of work done, suppose I can say the earth be a perfect sphere, say this is the sphere. It is the center O. Mass of the earth is capital M. We are taking here the points. Say here draw this figure. Now say this is the point A, here is the point B, here is the point P. The distance from O to P is R. The distance from A to B is dx, small distance. The distance from O to A is x. Now, if W is the amount of work done in bringing a body of unit mass, say m naught, from infinity to a point P, एक बॉडी को इंफिनिटी से, सपोज ये इज एन इंफिनिटी, यू आर टेकिंग द बॉडी फ्रॉम इंफिनिटी एंड टेकिंग एट अ पॉइंट पी इन द ग्रेविटेशनल फील्ड विदाउट एक्सेलरेशन, देन द ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल, देन द ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल एट पी वुड बी दैट इज डब्ल्यू बाई एम नॉट सर. यस, it is a scalar quantity because work done is scalar. So what is the unit of gravitational potential at a point in SI system? That is joule per kg. Joule per kg. What is the dimensional formula? Write down the dimensional formula of work and mass. You will get m naught L2 T minus 2. This is the result. This is the dimensional formula of gravitational potential. Now, if I want to get expression for the gravitational potential, then what we have to do? Here, it is the earth of a perfect sphere, say of radius R. Mass is capital M. The mass of the earth can be supposed to be concentrated at this point O. I want to calculate the gravitational potential at a point P here, where OP is equal to R. This R is greater than to that of radius. Join OP and produced onwards, take a two points A and B on this line such that OA is equal to X and AB is equal to DX, small distance. So the gravitational force of attraction on a body of unit mass at a point A will be, F comes out to be, F is equal to G M1 M21 divided by distance X square. So this I can write GM by X square. This is the force of attraction here. Then small amount of work done in bringing a body from A to B, say of distance dx. So what is the work done here? dw is equal to force into displacement, that is dx. यहां से यहां तक लेके आ रहे हैं. This is F dx. So put it here. That is gm by x square dx. This is the work done. Then the total work done in bringing the body of unit mass from infinity to the point P can be obtained by integrating this expression. Within the limit, x is equal to infinity here to x is equal to R. So I can integrate it. Integration of dw is equal to integration of gm by x square dx. Within the limit infinity to R. Yes. Integrate it. Gm may be taken out. Integration of 1 by x square, I know the formula. Integration of x and dx is equal to x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So I can write here, that is gm divided by x minus sign infinity to R. Integration of 1 by x square with respect to x, you can get it from here. X to the power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. That is x to the power minus 1 divided by minus 1. This is minus 1 by x, which we are here. Now open the limit. I can write minus gm 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. Here minus gm is equal to 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. That is equal to minus gm by r. This work done is the measure of gravitational potential. This work done is measured as a gravitational potential at a point P. So I can write Vp is equal to W is equal to minus gm by r. This is the expression. This is the gravitational potential at a point is always negative. Suppose r is equal to infinity. So I can write from this equation Vp is equal to 0. The gravitational potential is maximum, that is 0 at infinity. At infinity. At the surface of the earth, the gravitational potential would be minus gm by r. This is at the surface of earth. Okay, so this is all about today. Bye.